大家好，到最兴奋的时刻就是训练口技的一个 session 了。然后这里啊就是 Lightning Talk。那大家进来的时候在那个报到柜台会看到有这个箱子。那每个人都可以把你们想要分享的主题呢投进来这里面。我每天中午12点会抽出，就 randomly 抽出有一些想讲的人。然后在这个最后的 session， 大家就可以在5分钟之内分享任何你想讲的东西，任何事情，你可以 show off 你的技术啊，然后或者是你可以求婚啊，如果是女朋友是工程师应该会很嗨，但如果不是的话可能就 good luck。 好，然后今天我来抽的时候有一件有点神秘的事情，就是我怎么抽都抽到日本人，所以今天就是5位里面有4位是日本人。然后我觉得这证明了一件事，就是台日友好的关系。好，然后我讲一下这个 Lightning Talk 的规则，大家可以讲5分钟嘛，然后到了4分钟的时候，我们会用两指，我觉得你们要不要跟我做一下，就是用两指，我会示意，然后大家一起这样子用两指鼓掌，我们先用非常有礼貌的方式，因为日本人很喜欢礼貌嘛。好，两指鼓掌，哎，跟我做一下，不然很干。好，那接着5分钟到的时候呢，我们就不再礼貌了，我们就是用很粗残的方式，然后去鼓励这个讲者可以下台喽，就是时间已经到了。好，那接着因为今天讲者有很多是不讲中文的，所以我就稍微介绍一下，就是用英文讲一下规则。Hi, hi everyone. I'm the chair of the Lightning Talk session, and today we have 5 speakers. Most of them are from Japan, and the rule is, each of them can speak for 5 minutes. And when time gets to 4 minutes, we just use 2 fingers to clap and to notify them is they are running out of time. And when the time gets to 5 minutes, we just clap, like do normal clap, to tell them that time's up. So the first one we have Daisuke, to talk about Minecraft education and Python. 这里有人玩过 Minecraft 吗？举手。哦，那你们应该会蛮有共鸣的。Let's have play Minecraft. So welcome, Daisuke.
Okay, hello everyone. My presentation title is Minecraft Education and Python. Okay. Self-introduction, my name is Daisuke Saito. Please call me Daisuke. I am a university teacher and a Microsoft innovative educator expert in Japan and a PyCon JP 2090 content team leader. Yeah, so do you know Minecraft? Okay, so I will talk about Minecraft education. Minecraft education suitable for programming learning and programming learning so with make code. However, Minecraft education cannot use Python. So, I want to use Python and I want to draw so illustration in MIEE. So I developed so simple environment so for MIEE so use Python. So okay, and sorry, so this code so run draw illustration okay. So run Python code Minecraft also drop illustration. Minecraft. Python code. The module. Build a block. Agent. Yeah. So I can develop Python environment. Okay, please finish my LT. Thank you very much.
Well, it's not even 4 minutes. Okay, so next one. Thank you, Daisuke. And next one, we have Yoshida to speaking introduction useful tools. And about Yoshida, he's also chairman of PyCon Japan 2019. So maybe later on, we can share some exchange some experience about organizing PyCon. So welcome, Yoshida.
Hi. My lightning talk is introduction or with useful PyCon JP tools. So, who am I? I'm PyCon JP 17 and this. Eh? Ah, 画面がおかしい。あれ？さっきも来た。失礼。出てなかった。あれ？映った？OK、OK。おかしい。はい。Okay, I'm 17 and 18 and this year's PyCon JP chair. About 100 people came and, so that's right, quickly go. And another community work, local Linux users group and Debian study group and my hobby is go to hot springs. So last year I went to Kamata, Hakone, Saitama, Nagano, Nagoya, Osaka, Ishikawa, Matsuyama, Binchu and Singapore. That hot springs. So last day I went to Binchu. Yes. And do you know the PyCon JP? Yes. PyCon JP is so many long time, about 9 years scale. And third biggest PyCon J PyCon. And the PyCon JP 19, it ended Tuesday. So already it ends. So many people are coming. So quickly. So tools are using tools today introduced. So many tools are using. So over the 50 tools. So main first as a ABC budget system. So A rank is necessary expenses for holding. So and revenue that will surely come. And B rank is a normal expense and normal income. And C type is the cost of the dream. And maximum income. So balance the expense and cost, expense and cost and income. So we a success to the budget. Yes, and very easy sample budget. Yes, this one is a very very small conference. Yes, and zero is a conference only use the conference data. Use the smartphone application replaces the walkie-talkie. Yes. Wi-Fi or another internet connection used the very useful and low cost. And it's very convenient. When you use a headset or something, I like this one. So this Bone Conduction headset, I like this series, Aftershot series, yes. It's very easy, so sound talking and from directory, and another session if talk with normally, yeah. So it's very useful. And Slack bot, and so it's a very useful the tools. So many keywords are registered, over 30 keyword using. So many. So Slack bot API is very useful too. So we using the so Slack PyCon JP bot. Yes, it's writing by the Python. Yes. So many functions with that bot. Yes, it's I like the plus plugin. It gives thanks for the staff. It's nice. So many a lot of give thanks. So goes okay. Sorry.
Are?
あれ何これ何か変になった終わった OK
Thank you Yoshida 谢谢 Yoshida 还是硬要把它讲完的概念那我刚发现因为我有点小资所以大家可能要有时候往下看一下才能看到我的好，那下一个呢，一样是 PyCon Japan 的那个志工。好，那我们欢迎Naotaka， 他想要讲 recap PyCon Japan 2019。那我觉得很好奇，他要怎么把那么多天的一个那个 conference 浓缩在他现在的五分钟里面呢？我们期待。
Okay, hello everyone. I will talk about PyCon JP this year. Who am I? I'm Naotaka Yokoyama. Please call me Nao. Twitter is this ID. I'm in PyCon JP 2019 program committee. And I am a server-side engineer. Yesterday, I enjoyed Taipei, temple and demon, mango ice cream, and something.Oh, yeah. Do you know PyCon JP?
Yeah.
Did you come to PyCon JP 2019? Hey, please raise your hand. Anyone? Oh, thank you. Oh, 18%. Today's 80 speaker from PyCon JP. What's happened? Anyway, okay. PyCon JP, this year's PyCon JP schedule is follows. 4 days, one.Sprint, two, one tutorial, and two conference. Okay, time is okay, yeah. Okay, this year's participant is total over 1,000. And talks near 48 talks. Conference day, conference day's keynote is Corey Arasov. He is also the self-taught programmer. And this is for...Books for programming beginner, and this is a bestseller. Okay, this is a photo in conference day. Thank you for speakers from Taiwan. And maybe Ivor. I'm hosted Lightning Talks in PyCon JP.
Okay, conference day two. Day two, the keynote speaker is Makoto Koike. He is Python farmer. What is Python farmer? He is a farmer, but he was an engineer. Then he made automated vegetable sorting system with Python and deep learning. Okay, this is photo in conference day two. This cute robot working Linux and Python. And, tadokanai na, okay. Okay, are, haitteru? Working? Okay, yeah. This last photo is, thank you, shushie. Okay. Left side photo is about a poster session for community in Python community in Japan. In Japan, many Python community, in local Python community, not only Tokyo, Hokkaido to Okinawa, so many community in Japan. Okay. Right side photo is a lightning talk in second day. She's talk is very impressive. She was not engineer last year, but she came to PyCon JP 2018. She was a very affected NLT in the last year. So after PyCon JP 1980, she became a Python engineer. She talks this experience in this year's PyCon. So very impressive. Okay, see you next PyCon JP. PyCon JP 2020 will be 28-29 August at Tokyo. Thank you for listening. I'm looking forward to seeing you at next PyCon JP. Thank you.
Thank you, Naokata. 感觉要揪团去明年的 PyCon JP 了。好，那下一个呢，一样是 PyCon JP 的那个的志工。好，然后我们今天这个是 Nikki， 他要讲 Prepare PyCon JP 2019 with Python。Welcome。
Okay, let's begin my LT. Prepare PyCon JP 2019 with Python. This is my self-introduction. Please call me Nikki. I'm from PyCon JP too. And I'm PyCon JP program committee member. Do you know PyCon JP? you are already know PyCon JP fully. So next slide. This is my first PyCon Taiwan, and this is my first time abroad. So I really enjoy PyCon Taiwan, so I appreciate all staff. Thank you very much. And I know that Python is a staff of PyCon Taiwan too, because the site of PyCon Taiwan made by Django, Python. And Python is also a staff of PyCon JP. Python worked very hard in preparation of PyCon JP. In this LT, I will share you how Python supported PyCon JP. So this is contents. And now, introduction is end, and I talk you about situation and solution. Situation. What Python did? Python supported application of developer sprint. Python was committed to publishing sprint themes. Our tool, this is Compass. Compass is a web application by Be Proud Inc. to manage applications of an event. It is free to use. In Japan, Compass is used in many events about IT, not only Python events, also other language events. And this is Compass feature, questionnaire. We can create a questionnaire form, and participants will submit this form in applying the event. And in PyCon JP Sprint, There are two types of participants, attendees and readers. We want readers to submit information about their sprint projects. Issue is here. Only staffs can see answers of the questionnaire form, and we want to publish your page so that all the attendees can see sprint themes. We want to update the page regularly. So, automate this regularly stuff with Python. I talk about solution. So, only staffs can see and download the questionnaire answers as a CSV file. And we use Google Spreadsheet share with people who knows the link. And I create Python script, so update the page regularly. Script works. First, open the CSV file and select rows of readers and select columns because the CSV file includes email address and something. And selected data uploaded via Sheets API. I use Google API Python client and Google Auth. So solution is in this PC, first download the answers and second kick the script. So it's demo time. This is empty sheet and from command line. Kick this command. So uploaded the questionnaire answers. And operation, I use Slack reminder, and this says, hey, Nikki, please kick the script on Saturday morning. So summary, I shared how Python worked in preparation of PyConJP 2019 Developer Sprint. And select data from answer CSV file and upload to Google spreadsheet. I think Python can do more as a PyConJP staff, so I try create Django apps. I want to talk PyCon staffs about how they use Python in preparation of PyCon. Thank you for your attendance. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you for all the sharings from PyCon JP. 然后我们很谢谢这些日本的朋友，然后我觉得日本人真的很有趣，刚刚我在底下看的时候，他们上面的人在讲，然后虽然其他的工作人员都知道他们已经做过什么，他们听到上面的人讲还是会说哇，就发出惊叹的声音，非常的感兴趣，然后也会一直笑等等，就很日本人真的很有趣。好，然后下一位呢，我们有 Kiss 可以，他已经准备要上来了。那我见到 Kiss 的时候，我很惊讶，因为我有听说他有一个外号叫做围巾哥。那我今天发现他的围巾非常不一样，是一条蟒蛇。这是你对 Python 魂的体现吗？
你要问他。
哦，所以他有名字吗？
他就是 Kiss。
哦，他就是 Kiss。所以他也是你。
我只是替身了。
哦，对，这可能是一个哲学。
是，好。
啊，那我是想问一下，那你明天会背什么？
我也不知道，我也是。
好，谢谢。OK， 我们欢迎 Kiss。
こんにちは。So, do you know PyCon Japan? OK， 所以马上 go Chinese。So， 其实今年我们有组一团就已经去 PyCon Japan 了。Yes。That's very fun, great event. 不过回到我们今天要讲的 Lightning Talk， 那今天要讲的就是怎么在用 TouchPay 里面，跑在 VI 里面跑测试这样子。好，首先我会跑一个是编辑这个指令，第二个是我会按 Play， 第三个我会跑假装它是 Replay 这样子。好，首先现在我在 VI 里面，那我现在 demo 的状态是我自己的 project 之一。 就是一个叫做 Alog 的 project 这样子，那就是一个懒的 login system。 那如果你有用过 Python 内建的话，你至少要两行，那因为多一行我觉得很不舒服，所以我就写成只要一行就会动这样子。对，那 import Alog 就可以动了。好，那回归来这个我现在就要看一下，我要按，我只用一根手指哦，没有骗你。我按编辑，好，这个是我要编辑我要跑什么的，然后我现在按 play， 哦，它就在 VI 里面跑了测试这样子。那我现在再按 replay， 好，哦，又跑了一次这样子。那真的是这样吗？现在我来做工程师最常做的事情，就是这跑起来看起来没问题嘛。那我们现在要做的事情就是把写好的测试弄坏这样子，写好的 code 搞坏这样子，就我们最常做的事情。好，然后再按一次 play， 哎，两个 fail， 这样就是 demo 成功了。谢谢大家。那其实今天还有一个这个二合一的 Lightning Talk 里面，我还有 demo 说，哎，我要怎么用 AI 在我的 VIN 里面写 code 呢？好，我们把这些东西关掉。因为我右手受伤了，我只能用左手让你们笑了。哎，我把什么关掉了 ？Let me see this。好，那我现在在 VI 里面，你按 K 的话，它会跳出例如在 VI 里面跳出文件嘛。可是我现在想要看的是，我现在按，抱歉，左手还是能让你们笑，嗯。他什么时候更新的东西？我按 K 的话，他会跑出一个叫 Kit 的东西。好，那我现在回来哦。哎，他现在把这个 function 秀出来了。那我现在去看一个我想要看他文件的东西好了，看一下这个底线 error function。哦，他至少告诉我他 returns 有一个 string 这样子。那它还有其他功能，据说它可以帮你补完一整行，可是在我的经验里面还蛮有趣的，就是它的一整行跟你的一整行可能不太一样。我看一下有什么东西我可以玩的，这有 pass，我这边 pass 加一个不完，这也就是他跳出的那个，这后面有一个钻石哦，就是他跳出的那个 pipeline。糟糕，我快没有时间自我介绍了。Anyway， 好，那接下来是广告时间，就是这是我第三天的 talk， 会讲 GraphQL。那我是 Chris Young， 那我现在在 SharePoint 当工程师，也是台北打派的创办人，现在我们每个月会在台北办活动这样子，大概在九月底、十月底、十一月底、十二月底这样子。那介绍公司的时候呢 ，iShare 我们当然是拿那个 GitHub 出来，这样大家比较不会觉得，会比较熟悉。那我们有开放一个 Open Source。好，最后十秒我要讲的是，我已经讲完了。谢谢大家。
Do you know PyCon JP？ 我也很想玩这个梗。好，今天 Lightning Talk 就到这里，今天这里为止。然后明天的话，我还期待大家去投那个箱子，在注册的那个地方，就是报到处。那我明天中午一样会抽出来，然后下午会在这个荧幕上面会秀出我抽出的那一些人，然后欢迎大家来投，谢谢。